Ah, golden sweet honey. It's great in tea and yogurt, but don't get too attached. Believe it or not, a new study found that bees now make less honey. Find out why on NSF Science now. Believe it or not, in 2022, the U.S. consumed 125 million pounds of honey. That's a lot of honey. Makes you think honeybees have been pretty busy, right? They have an important job foraging millions of different flowers and bringing back collected nectar to the hive for production of honey, the very same that we buy at the store. However, a new study found that bees are now making less honey.
In this study, we found that there are regions of really high honey production, like in the northern Great Plains and along the Gulf Coast, that are really underpinned by the climate and soils of those different regions. And then we've also found that over the last 50 years, across the country, both in the high producing regions and the lower producing regions, we're seeing this decline in honey production.
NSF-supported researchers at Penn State have uncovered clues in the mystery of the missing honey.
Our study, to my knowledge, is the first that has looked at the taxonomic profile of soils and finding how soil productivity really relates to pollinator resources.
Sifting through 5 decades of data from across the U.S., the team analyzed factors that might be affecting honey yields.
We were looking across the entire U.S., for the last 50 years, which allowed us to really pick up on a lot of trends that maybe you wouldn't be able to. We're finding a really key role of soils as well as land use. So those are the factors that we were focusing on.
While soil and climate conditions set the baseline levels of honey production, they found that land use, herbicide application, and weather change influenced how much honey was produced each year. The more productive the soils were, the higher the honey yields.
What we were seeing is that there are these really key foundational factors, things like climate and soils, that are really having these bottom-up effects on how much honey can be produced in a given region. And then we were looking at that also, how those things have changed across time.
The team hopes their findings provide valuable insights that can be applied to improve models and design experiments to enable beekeepers to predict future honey yields, while helping growers and land managers protect and conserve the land for the wildflowers essential to honey production.